We design electronics for equipment makers. When asked to quote a design, our engineers do a careful review of the customer requirements, and if we can see ways to create the product, we will send you a proposal, including lead time, usually 18 to 20 weeks. Why does it take so long? You may be thinking that the electronic design process goes something like this. But it really looks more like this. When we design a circuit and simulate it, we have a pretty good idea of what it will do, but to see what will really happen, we have to lay out the board, build some, and test. And this means, as electrical engineers, we spend a lot of our life failing. Let's see why that is. Drawing the schematic is the fun part. It's complicated and challenging and creative. There's no one right approach for any function in a circuit. There are some common approaches, and starting from there, you evaluate so many trade-offs. Performance, space, costs, manufacturability. Experience tells you which approach has advantages under what circumstances, but that's just a starting point. You also have to account for how each function is affected by the rest of the design, and that's different for every single design. Here's where there are advantages of having an engineering department versus a lone designer. You can run your ideas by your teammates. They may see something you don't, and save you from wasting too much time on the wrong approach. Component selection is a big part of those first weeks. You can't just say op-amp, you have to say which op-amp, and that means studying the spec sheets, which have dozens of specs, and every spec has multiple dependencies on temperature and other factors. It gets easier with experience, but it still takes a lot of time. When you think you have a good design, you run computer simulations on areas you're not sure about. And if you work for a company that does formal design reviews, you run it by the review team. If you pass with only a few changes, that's great. Up to now, you've spent about 3 weeks on circuit design, and the fun part is over, because now you'll spend the next 10 to 20 weeks trying to figure out why it's not working. A circuit almost never works perfectly the first time. Maybe a signal is too noisy, or the timing is off, or it gets too hot sometimes. You won't know if the problem is the board layout, or hand assembly of the prototype, or a flaw in your design. So you embark on a series of experiments to analyze the problem, hypothesize about the cause, make a change that should fix it, test, and repeat until you figure it out. Then you move on to the next problem area. Sometimes a change that solves one problem creates a new one. You may back up to an earlier version and take a different path to avoid the new problem. Or keep driving forward and tackle the new problem from where you are. Troubleshooting is not as much fun as design, and people usually underestimate how long it can take. The biggest danger is failing to question your data and basic assumptions. Again, a team can help you spot this pitfall faster. Sometimes troubleshooting can inspire new inventions. For example, we recently designed a power supply the conventional way, and it worked fine under normal load, but not at half power. And over several more rounds of failing, we invented a wholly new approach, taking advantage of new silicon carbide MOSFETs and silicon gate drivers instead of conventional transformers. It's pretty cool. We're going to present a paper at our next technical conference. So given that 10% of our time is spent on design and 90% on troubleshooting, maybe 18 to 20 weeks for a complex electronic product looks a little more reasonable. As a customer, you can have more confidence that your vendor will meet the quoted lead time if you look for engineering teams with a culture of collaboration, experienced circuit designers on the team, and a commitment to staying up to date with the latest components and design techniques. Talk to Z-Axis about electrical engineering design services.